When you're working on a document, it's very beneficial to ask others to review it for you and to track the changes they make to the document. In Word 2013, Microsoft has introduced a new, cleaner view of track changes and a richer experience for adding comments and replying to comments. Let's have a look.
Here I have a proposal that I've been working on for a customer. Before I send it off, I'd like to ask Nora to review it for me. First, I'll add some comments to the document, highlighting things I want Nora to give feedback on. To insert a comment into a document, mark the text or object you want to comment on, click the Review tab, and then click New Comment. Now you can add your text into the comment bubble. Here, I'll ask if we should insert our corporate video into the document. If you have a profile picture added to your Office account, it will show up next to the comment. This provides the reviewer with a quick overview of who has added the comment. If you're using a real-time communication platform like Microsoft Link, you can also see if the person is online and communicate with him or her directly from within the document.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
I'll insert another comment further down in my document by clicking the paragraph heading in the navigation pane. I'll mark the section and ask Nora to insert a picture. Now I'm ready to ask Nora to review the document. To make sure that any changes that are made to the document are tracked, on the Review tab, click Track Changes. However, this is quite easy for someone to turn off by just clicking the Track Changes button again. If you click the little arrow on the Track Changes button, you'll see the option to lock tracking. This is a great option if you want to make sure that everyone who reviews the document tracks their changes. I'll click Lock Tracking and enter a password. Now the Track Changes button is grayed out and it can't be turned off without entering the password. Sometimes it can be hard to see if track changes are on or off, especially if you don't have the Review tab open. I recommend that you add track changes to your status bar so that you can always see if they're on or off. To do that, right-click the status bar and select Track Changes. Now you can easily see if track changes are on or off when you're working on a document. I'll save the document and then ask Nora to review it. To share the document, I'll click File, Share, Email, and then, since I have this document shared on our SharePoint intranet site where my colleagues can access it, I'll click Send as Link. This way, we avoid sending multiple large email attachments and we can all see the latest changes made to the proposal. I'll write the email to Nora asking her to review the document for me before I send it off to the customer tomorrow morning. Let's switch over to Nora to see what this looks like for her. Here we are, logged in as Nora, ready to review the document. To review a document, click the Review tab and make sure that Track Changes is turned on. In this case, the track changes have been locked down, so they can't be switched off without a password. Then, you can start making your changes. All changes, deletions, insertions, and formatting changes are tracked. In the tracking section on the Review tab, you can decide how your changes are displayed. In Word 2013, there is a new default view called Simple Markup. This view is less cluttered. It shows a red line where changes are made. To see the changes, just click on any red line to see the full markup. To collapse the view and go back to the simple view, click any red line again. You can also select View in the Tracking Display drop-down. To see the full markup, click All Markup. To see the document with all of your changes applied, click No Markup. And to see the original document without any of your changes applied, click Original. Here, I'll go back to the simple markup view. In Word 2013, reviewers can easily respond to comments, keeping discussions related to documents organized. Here, Nora responds to my comment regarding adding an online video. You can easily resize and move comments around by clicking the little arrow in the comments window. When Nora is done reviewing the document, she saves her changes and sends an email to Jacob with a link to the document, asking him to review the document as well. Now I'm back looking through the document that both Nora and Jacob have reviewed. To accept or reject changes that have been made to a document, click the Review tab. Here, I'll click Track Changes and then Log Tracking to unlock the tracking of the document. Here, I'll insert my password. To get a good overview of all the track changes that have been made to a document, on the Review tab, click Reviewing Pane. Here, I'll select Reviewing Pane Vertical. Here, I can see that 18 revisions have been made in total, and I can see that Nora and Jacob have made a number of different changes to the document. I'll change the display of the track changes to All Markup to see all changes. To start going through track changes, place your marker at the beginning of the document and click Next in the Changes section. This takes you to the first change made. Here I can see that the text for a solution was deleted. I can hover over the change to see who made it and when. To see this information as a balloon instead, I can click Show Markup, Balloons, and then select to show revisions in balloons. Now the details of the deletion are showed. I'll accept this change and move to the next. Here I can see that Nora has changed the formatting to italic. I don't agree with this change, so I'll just click Reject to keep the original formatting. I'll continue to accept and reject changes in the document as I see fit. Here Word stopped at the comment. I can see that both Nora and Jacob have replied positively. To delete a comment, go to the Comments section and click Delete. By deleting the first comment, the whole thread is deleted. If you agree with all proposed changes in the document, you can just click Accept All Changes in the document. Here, I'll select Accept All Changes and stop tracking. Now I can see in the Reviewing pane that no more revisions remain. Another great way to make sure that you don't have any hidden comments or changes is to inspect the document. To inspect your document, click the File tab, check for issues, and select Inspect Document. I'll save the document, and then I'm asked what I want to inspect the document for. Here, I'll uncheck all options except for the first, which is to check for comments, revisions, versions, and annotations. Here I can see that no items were found, so I can be sure that there are no hidden revisions here. Now I'm ready to share the document with my customer. Yesterday, I sent a blog article called How to Deliver a Successful Presentation to Jacob for him to review. Here he sent me the document with his changes. I'll open it up to see what changes he's made. Unfortunately, the track changes wasn't turned on, so there's no way for me to know what changes he's done to the document. Luckily, there's a way for Word to find these changes by using the Compare tool. To compare two documents, click the Review tab and then Compare. First, select the original document. Here, I'll open up the document I sent to Jacob for him to review. Then, open up the revised document where the changes were made. You can choose to label the changes. Here, I'll mark them with Jacob's initials, JM, and then click OK. Now you can see the original document up to the right, the revised document with his changes underneath, and the document with the marked changes to the left. In the revision pane, I can see that he made 5 changes to the document. Now I can use the reviewing tools to walk through the changes one by one. I'll approve the changes he made, and then, when I've gone through all changes, I'll save the document. Many people find the tracking feature of Word a bit difficult to use, but once you get the hang of it, it's a really useful tool that can save you a lot of time when collaborating on documents.